Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's take a look at how you can get transit directions using the Maps app on your Mac. So a new feature in the Maps app in El Capitan is the ability to get directions using public transportation. Now it's not available in all cities, but I'll use one where it is available, New York City right here, as an example. And you can just go into directions here to get directions as you would before, but you notice that you have drive, walking directions, and now transit directions. So let's say we want to get from the Met to the Mets. So after hitting the big directions button here, we can use searches to find things. So we'll search for the Met here, and there's the Metropolitan Museum of Art, and then we'll search for Citi Field and select that. Now I still have driving directions selected, so it's going to give me driving directions, but I'm going to switch to transit and it will give me some transit options. And once it calculates different routes, it's going to give me a selection of them. So I have three different routes here and I can switch between them to see which one I like better. And it gives you an estimated time. It also gives you some other stuff like how much walking is involved, and you can see a summary of what the route involves. So you can hit details here and actually get some detailed instructions on how to get from one to the other that you can then follow. You can also change the time. So say I'm not leaving right now, I'm leaving in 30 minutes. It'll recalculate the route based on current schedules, give me estimated times for those, and also it'll rearrange them as to which one is more convenient for you. You can also do custom here, so you can set a custom time. So if I'm not leaving till later, or I want to set an arrival time and say, well, I want to arrive by a certain time, and then it will calculate everything backwards, letting me know when I should leave to arrive there. Now, when I first calculated the directions, you probably got a quick view of all the transit routes, and you may think that could be useful to see, and you actually can see that. You can turn directions off here, and then under view, make sure you've selected transit to show. So you can, in the normal view, it's just map, but I can select transit. Now I have this cool transit map of my area, providing that transit information is available for the city that you're in now. Of course, Apple's going to be adding in more cities as time goes on. You'll see announcements for these. So if they don't have it for your city, check back in a month or two and see if they've added it then. People who have been using iOS, of course, have been used to being able to navigate using maps. And it's kind of awkward to do it on a Mac because you're not exactly taking your MacBook with you on the subway and using that to navigate around. But it can be useful to see these directions, and then once you have them, you can actually do things with them, like print them out. So you can see here I've selected these directions again. I've selected this route here and I've looked at the details. I can go to print and I can see what it's going to look like by using the open and preview, and I can see I get three pages here. One is the map, and then I get directions on two other pages. But I can do other things as well. I can use the share button here to send these directions to, say, my iPad, which I may have. I can email them, and I can even do things like messages and other stuff like that, add them to notes. So there are a lot of different ways to get these directions from your Mac to some device or some method of reviewing them as you're actually traveling.